Hey guys. So this is recording on my iPhone, which kind of sucks. Somebody asked me recently, my bench is a little dirty, pardon me. Whole garage is dirty. Somebody asked me recently how to sharpen a chisel. So I figured I'd, you know, just like everybody else does now, I'd make a video. Here I've got a chisel that has somewhat recently been sharpened, but the edge is pretty hammered. I don't think you can see that from where you are, but it's got some nicks in this thing. I was actually using this up at my cabin. There's some little nicks right in there. I was using this up at my cabin to square up some edges where I had cut out some floor. And this is a chisel that I actually just have hang around in my toolbox. This thing has been kind of abused. It's been hit with a steel face hammer, which I really don't like, but you know, I did it. I have a love-hate relationship with these chisels. I think if you are just starting out in woodworking, these are a damn good chisel to buy. The steel is hard and they hold an edge really, really well. My problem is that the plastic is with the plastic handles, and they don't balance as well as a wood handle chisel. This one, it feels the feel here. I can't even describe it to you. The shape of the handle is fine. I don't mind the shape. This one's a little more rounded. This one might be a little more comfortable for me, but these guys, the plastic handle just bugs me. And this one, I mean, you can see right here, it's been just been beat to shit. Anyway, so to sharpening. I have diamond stones here. You can use sandpaper. I guess everybody probably knows that. I really like the diamond stones. These are cheap diamond stones. If I had this to do over again, I would buy the ones that are a little bit wider. Everybody really likes to, you know, build a little caddy for these and all of that shit. My problem with that is that it makes it hard to get to the edge, especially of the center one. In this case, you can move these out and then get to the edge of the center one. So I just leave them alone. What I like to do is they have these little feet on them. And I'm sure that somebody will argue with me somewhere, but I like to hang that over the edge of the bench, okay? Which makes it at a slight incline, but I feel like I can work with that. And I can keep my hands perpendicular to that. So, lapping fluid. This is straight out of Paul Sellers, guys. Straight out, like you can watch him do this, probably way better than me. But I figured I'd show you. This is just straight up soapy water. I think he uses glass cleaner or something else. I don't know. Anyway, it's just soapy water. I use soapy water in other things that I do to detect leaks. Anyway, so take chisel. Hold it at about 30 degrees. Now, if you don't have a 30-degree bevel on there, you're going to need to make one. And if you need to make one, the easiest thing to do is to buy one of these handy-dandy sharpening guides. I like these okay. You just have to follow the directions and how they work. This right now is not what I'm going to do because this chisel is in good enough shape to do it. Anyway, down pressure, even pressure across the end. You can see my fingers. I bend this finger to shorten it a little bit so that this finger, these two fingers are roughly in the same place on there. Okay, hold it at about 30 degrees. I can feel the facet and then give it take off just a little bit of material. And what we're gonna do is flip it over, wipe it off. Okay, and you can see that I have uniform scratches all the way across. Okay, I don't know if you can see that or not, but anyway, it's uniform coarse scratches. I've actually touched off right here with a very fine stone, so you can see the difference in the scratches. And that is a utility thing for me, so that I can see where I've been. Just need the glasses for just a second here. I just want to look at the edge. So I've got the edge. I'm going to give this just a little more. There's one little more, I don't know if you can see it or not, but there's one more little nick right there that I want to get out. Okay, wipe it off. I think we're good. Yeah, So again, uniform scratches all the way across. Okay. I don't know if you can see that or not. I'm not good at making videos. Anyway, wipe off your stone. Dump the sawdust that you just got on it off. This will be pretty quick from here on out. Okay. Run this back and forth just a little. Oops. Wipe it off. Okay, now we've got finer uniform scratches. They're all across this surface, okay? All fine, okay? Sometimes you will get not uniform scratches. That means that you are pushing either your bevels off, which you need to start over and reinitialize the chisel with this guy, or it means that you're not pushing in a uniform manner. So again, the fingers matter. So I shortened this one a little bit by bending it and lay my index finger flat. Little piece of wood under there. Okay, fine stone. This is where I actually really pay attention, is on the fine stone. Okay, go slow and push hard. Something noteworthy on a brand new chisel or on a chisel that you haven't used before, it's worth taking a piece of sandpaper and just knocking off the corners a little bit. The corners can be, they can cut the shit out of you on these things, especially when you're like, you're going like this. Just something that I do that makes them a lot more comfortable to use. Anyway, now you've got the finest uniform scratches, except for right there at the corner. See that? That's because I wasn't pushing in a uniform manner. I don't know if you can see that or not. Anyway, so let's get that dealt with real quick. Okay. There it is. Okay. That should be much cleaner right there. Okay, now I'm gonna take this, and I like to just touch off on the back here and just give it a quick swirl. Okay. Wipe it off. Okay, now let's have a look here real quick. Yeah. Okay, that looks good. I've got uniform scratches all across the back there. I've got uniform scratches all across the front here. Okay, so we should be in good shape. Okay, so this should be nice and sharp now. This edge is uniform. Notice it's square. You can see right here where I flattened it. You really want this area flat, and you can do that by being on a flat stone and just and rubbing the chisel like this. The reason that you want that, in this case, these dovetails are actually too, these are much smaller. I would be using obviously a much smaller chisel, but you need to be able to register that flat up against that surface right there. So that is really, really important, that that is dead flat. And I don't know, if there's interest, I'll make another video. Anyway, so yeah, that's what we've got. So this is in pretty good shape. You could use this just like this. I do follow the sort of Paul Sellers guide here. I like to wipe these off pretty good. And I like to use a strop to polish them up just a little bit. Here's my strop. This is just a, I'm gonna move the camera so that you guys can see what I'm doing. All this is just, it's actually a piece of maple with a piece of oak glued to it and a piece of leather glued to that. This is actually an old leather jacket from Shauna's aunt. Right, put that in the vise. Everybody likes to, oh, I need to charge up my, my strop. With buffing compound. This buffing compound, I've had this bar for 5 years, and I've probably used it twice a week for 5 years. This is more fucking buffing compound than anybody needs in their entire life. I would highly suggest that if you need some of this, or you decide you want some of it, let me know and I'll break you off a chunk of it. Don't buy it. So charge this thing up, even though it probably doesn't need it. Okay. Paul Sellers does 30 strokes. I'll probably do about that. We're only dragging here, because if you push, you're gonna cut the leather. Like if I did like this, see how I cut the leather? We don't wanna do that. Okay, once on the back. that just gets the burr off. Okay, which I probably should have shown you guys that burr, but I didn't, so pardon me. Anyway, there it is. Okay, highly polished. Okay, so that's a sharp chisel. How do we know it's sharp? It's a good question. Finds a sharp chisel. A lot of people will say, oh, well, will it cut paper? Well, this will cut the S out of paper. It will also cut the S out of you. So be careful. Get started. I just wiggle just a little bit. Okay. And it's cutting paper. Cuts paper pretty well. I like to use a little different test. My favorite test is actually with woodworking. This is a piece of hardwood. This is actually a piece of cherry, which... if you've ever worked with cherry, cherry is lovely. This is a short piece, so I'm going to do this at kind of a funny angle. I think you can see that. I will go ahead and take a square, and I'll go ahead and take and score just a simple knife line. Hang on, I'm gonna open up my knife here. Just a simple knife line on the edge. Okay, so we're gonna nice and light, a little harder, really hard, maybe even really hard again. Okay, so now take this and flatten it out just a little bit. I'm gonna just come in here and pare. Okay, that's the first thing I do. I pare, take a full width paring, see how it feels. This should go in really easy. Again, be careful, this is sharp as hell. Okay, see how that went? Okay, I'm going to take just a little more off right here. Now, here's the real test of a sharp chisel in my mind. Cross grain cut. Okay, and particularly cross grain cut at the end. What does it do at the end? Does it blow out the grain or does it cut smoothly? So, real light cut. Push, 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 push really lightly. How does that feel? Does that make a nice curly chip? It sure does. Okay, and at the end... it didn't blow out the grain. That is what I'm looking for in a nice sharp chisel. Okay, cross grain cut, very, very simple. Nice, even, smooth finish. There's a little bit of moisture, I think, still on the back of this chisel. That's where that came from. Okay, we can do it again. Nice and easy. Okay, all right. So now we could even take this. And if we really wanted to see how sharp it was, okay, register, right? And then push down. Okay, see how it made a line there? It made the knife wall deeper, register, and then push down. Okay, I'm not using a mallet here. Okay, register, push down. Okay, nice and flat, nice and straight. Back in the vise. Again, a nice even cross grain cut. Okay, a little bit of fiber there. That's okay. Take that off like that. Okay, the side might have a little come off like that. Anyway, that's the beginning of a rabbit. We don't need to talk about that right now, but that's how I sharpen a chisel. Hope everybody has a lovely day.